Hey guys, welcome to the sounding mind, the loud inside voice that speaks the truth and nothing but the truth to power. This is the channel that focuses on exposing the hypocrisy of the left agenda. Ah, as always, woke language, we're very concerned. I'll back you all the way through because I care about social justice. You know, lefties love to act as if their viewpoints are so important and that they can do whatever they want and get away with it because they are so righteous or self-righteous. Nevertheless, business is business at the end of the day. And if you've lost the customer or the public support, it's game over. It's absolutely over. I can't believe I'm saying this, folks. What, for the 20th time? The situation for Bud Light just got worse, literally. In fact, this headline may be the worst one yet. Today's Bud Light video wasn't even something I had planned to create. I was storing a few articles for a future movie, but I suddenly realized that I needed more information. The most recent rumor that we've heard claims that Costco is about to discontinue selling Anheuser-Busch's Bud Light, at least in some areas. According to rumors, Bud Light recently earned the Star of Death, also known as the Death Star. Therefore, it's possible that the product won't be refilled there anymore. It's actually exactly what we've been saying, which is amusing. Simply said, the sales aren't high enough to warrant their presence in these retail spaces. They are losing their positions in the shelves and coolers. For Bud Light, Phase 2 is the final chapter. Phase 3 has not yet begun. In other words, I'll probably say it again. Bud Light's situation just got worse. Let me demonstrate to you all exactly what is happening. Let's take a look. Get woke. Go broke. Roll the tape. We have some things to get into. Okay, folks, take a look at this Newsweek headline over here. Photos show Bud Light with Costco Death Star amid plummeting sales. Photos shared on social media show that Bud Light has allegedly received Costco's so-called Star of Death, a small asterisk at the top right-hand corner of items' price tags, which the retailer uses to signal a product will no longer be restocked once it is sold out. Images shared on Twitter showed the price tags for Bud Light beer at different Costco stores, all marked with the Star of Death. It's unclear where the stores are located. One of the pictures shows the beer being sold at $14.97 for a 2x12 pack, which a Twitter user said was Costco practically giving away Bud Light. Here's the tweet from a Twitter user named Colleen that, at Costco this morning, practically giving away Bud Light. I mean, that price is unbelievable. 2x12 packs. That's basically a case of $1.24 for $1.15. Then we have another Twitter user going by the name of Shark in the Water. Costco says, Star of Death for Bud Light. It will not be restocked. Check out the picture. Additionally, we have another one from a different store right over here. It appears like Costco is losing interest in Bud Light. It's possible that Costco won't simply resupply this particular item and will switch it out for another Bud Light or Anheuser-Busch better item, but I highly doubt that would happen. I mean, I don't think anyone should give Bud Light the benefit of the doubt at this point. Disaster is brewing here, and we have been saying it exactly. I anticipated this a few weeks ago, saying that store customers would simply cease refilling it and remove it from the shelf. And by retail purchasers, I don't just mean customers who shop at physical stores, but rather the people who purchase merchandise directly from businesses. And to be honest, it appears that we have arrived already. It appears to be a little early. The Goliath that was once Bud Light no longer exists. They are no longer influential. And at this point, Bud Light presumably just gets responses along the lines of, well, listen, we can't do anything. We are aware of the length of our relationship. Although we appreciate your desire for us to support you, the fact that this product is not selling makes it impossible for us to continue supplying it. You know, woke intentions and all, good intentions, business relations. At some point, if a product is not selling, it must be taken off the shelves. It's that easy. It's not difficult. Consumers have this kind of power. In essence, consumers determine what is offered and what is not. It's game over if consumers decide they've had enough and don't want anything to do with it any longer. And if this keeps happening, well, it's really game over because if Bud Light sales are down now, well, just think of what they'll be like when they're no longer stocked in major retailers, especially a place like Costco. There are presently close to 600 Costco warehouses in the United States, which translates to 600 stores, and it's possible that majority of them are eliminating Bud Light or no longer carrying it. That translates into a significant loss of income for Anheuser-Busch. Additionally, it frequently has a snowball effect. If Costco decides to take them off the shelf, it's probable that the following retailer and the following retailer will start doing the same thing. And it's feasible that 1,000, maybe even more than 1,000 retailers will completely stop selling Bud Light. Of course, we haven't arrived yet. And a lot of this really is speculation. It's difficult to say whether the rumored star of death, actually signifies that Costco will no longer carry Bud Light. It could also indicate other things. But once more, I'll use the same reasoning I did before. I wouldn't be giving Bud Light a second chance. Everything around them has been falling apart, including everything they touch. Anyone that associates with this brand in collapse has the exact same perspective. Here's a funny tale that I've been holding in reserve, in fact. Garth Brooks cancels his remaining Vegas shows. People stopped coming. Garth Brooks had no choice but to cancel the rest of his Las Vegas contract, 11 shows altogether, after ticket sales went in the toilet. "Nobody wants to see me right now," Brooks told Allied correspondent Skip Tetheluda. "I'm hoping it will pass. All I said was I'm going to serve Bud Light at my new bar." Tetheluda asked Brooks about the a-hole's comment and why he would berate nearly his entire fan base. "I didn't see it that way," he responded. "I was just trying to be fair to everyone." Garth Brooks referred to those who were boycotting the company as a-holes before standing up for Bud Light and announcing that he would serve it at his new bar. And, well, everything is crumbling around him. 11 shows were canceled by him. At this point, his bar is probably going to fail. Even though I'm laughing, I suppose it is sad in a way. Nevertheless, it is what it is. People just need to get the message that this awakened thing doesn't work, you know, and take a hint. It's a terrible idea, not at all. It's a terrible drug. I understand, you know, the attention and the sense of being a hero.
I can sort of understand that, but it's not worth it. You end up taking the way of Bud Light, Target, Garth Brooks, or the newest edition, Ben and Jerry's, who decided it would be a fantastic idea not to celebrate American freedom on July 4th. No, of course, nothing patriotic, but rather to denigrate America and assert that stolen land should be returned to the indigenous people, only to be ratioed into oblivion, lose their parent company, Unilever, roughly $2 billion in market capitalization, and of course, to be completely humiliated by real indigenous people or an indigenous tribe. Indigenous tribe wants Ben and Jerry's to return stolen land that their headquarters is built on. After this well-known ice cream brand, Ben and Jerry's, made a contentious appeal for America to return stolen land, members of an indigenous group who are descended from Native Americans reportedly indicated interest in reclaiming the territory. We are therefore waiting for Ben and Jerry's to act morally. You first go for it? Do it, then perhaps we'll think about following suit, is the standard attitude to liberals and their activist demands. You will never, because these wokesters are full of, you know what? Of course. Because of this, no one likes them, no one has faith in them, and everything that is woke ends up being ish. I adore this brand collapsing new trend where being woke results in entire brand collapse rather than simply a minor pushback. It's a terrific new standard, in my opinion. It is lovely. I'm hoping that the situation for Bud Light keeps getting worse. That's all I got for you guys today. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to hit a like and possibly subscribe to the channel. I'm going to get out of here now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.